Hello, Apple Valley High School Fab Lab students. It's Mr. Lee, and today what we're going to do is prepare a file for cutting with our print and cut vinyl cutter. So what I've done is actually opened up a couple pieces of software. I have Adobe Illustrator opened up, and I have Adobe Photoshop opened up. And if you're using Illustrator 2020, you want to set the workspace to the Essentials Classic. And I can show you that in a minute, where to find that link. So the first thing I'm going to do is find an image. I like the Minnesota Twins, and I like their old logo. So I'm going to select an image like this one, and I'm going to look for a JPEG. You can also use PNGs. Sometimes they're protected. We're not going to sell these, so we can use images that are copyrighted. So I'm going to change the file name to Twins, and I'm going to save that to my desktop so I can find it. Then what I'm going to do now is open up Photoshop, and I'm going to directly open that file. So you can tell I'm in Photoshop because there's a PS at the top. And in the window, the workspace, you want it the Essentials Classic, because that's going to be similar to what I'm using. So I'm going to go File, Open, and I labeled it Twins 1, because I already had another image similar to it. And you can tell that it's got kind of a border around it and a little bit of a shadow, which is fine. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to create the cut contour, which is going to be an outline. So I'm going to go to this fill tool and then select black for the fill. So it's on black already. And then I'm going to click fill and turn that all black. Now, you'll notice when I selected the fill tool, I already had that paint bucket up, but the little drop arrow, that allows you to pick different things. So it might be selected to gradient or 3D. Drop tool. So we want it for the paint bucket. And now what I'm going to do is use this magic wand tool. And what I can do with the magic wand is I can select just the outline. So I'm going to copy that. And then I'm going to create a new file directly from that copy. So when I go to File, New, it's going to use the information that I have on the clipboard from what I just copied. And then I'm going to say OK. And you notice that the size of that is the same as the size of what we copied. And then I'm going to paste that image in. And there's my outline. That's going to be my cut contour. So what I got to do now is kind of change the background. So I'm going to go into here and just select any color I want and click OK, and then go to the paint bucket and fill it. And now what I'm going to do is get rid of that black background. So I'm going to go down to here and flip it around and fill the background, and that is going to be my cut contour. I'm going to make that black. Illustrator would still probably image trace it, but it'll be easier if it's all black. So I'm going to save this file as a JPEG, and I'm going to call it Twins 1, because that's what I named the other file, Outline. And I'm going to create it as a JPEG and save it to my desktop. And I always select the maximum quality, because then you'll have less issues when you're image tracing. And that one's ready. And then this one is already set. So I'm not going to save that because I have the original image. So I'm going to go into Illustrator now. And you notice I'm in Illustrator because it has the AI in the top. I'm going to create a new file. And I'm going to have my width and height 12 inches. My units are inches. Here, the color mode doesn't really matter, so under Advanced, you can leave it. I always do it at high per pixel as possible. So So I'm going to click OK. I'm going to turn on my rulers with the Control and the R key, and turn on the grid with the Control and the Quote key. And then I'm going to place that outline. I'm going to do that first. So I'm going to go File, Place, and then find my Twins 1 outline. And I'm going to use the Control minus key to zoom out so you can kind of see my whole workspace. I'm going to resize this eventually, but I'm going to just do the default image trace. So if you go up to image trace, you can see you can do different types of image traces. I'm going to do the default. And then I have to expand it. And now what I'm going to do is right click on the image and isolate it. I don't want this white rectangle. So I selected the white rectangle and I'm going to hit the delete key. And that'll take out that. I'm still in the isolation mode. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to open up, go to Window, and go to Pathfinder. And I already have that pulled up, but you have to select that. And I'm going to select the image. So it's highlighted. It's got blue border around it. And then I'm going to go over to here and find the tool that says Outline. And so it took out all the color except for the outline. But if you notice, if I go to the stroke and then up here, the stroke has a width of 0 right now. We need it something other than 0. So I'm just going to type in a 1 and hit the Tab key. And now it has a stroke of 1, but it's black. For the image to cut, the machine has to see a special path. And so we're going to go into swatches. So I go to Window and then swatches, and you notice I have that already selected. This is my swatches menu. And we loaded the VersaWorks swatch, and that's in the other library. So you have to click on the swatch libraries menu and then scroll down to Roland VersaWorks. And select that. This pink line will be the cut contour. So I have the stroke pulled up front, and then I'm going to select, I have this selected, I'm going to hit the cut contour, and you notice it changed the stroke to pink. And so when I select off of this, you can see that pink line. That's going to tell the machine to cut. Now what I want to do is make the image the correct size. So I'm going to go to my transform link, which a lot of times you have to scroll all the way down on the laptops, and open that up. That's this. And this gives me information about how big the image is and where it's located. And I'm going to put it at 0, 0, so up in the corner. And then what I'm going to do is besides putting it at 0, 0, I'm going to get it the correct size. This chain here links the X and the height and width together. Make sure that's checked. It's easier to resize things. So my height is the bigger dimension. So I'm going to make that 5 inches. So that it'll be about 5 by 4. So that's ready to go. So if I click off, you can see that's the cut contour. So if we just sent that to the printer, it would cut a nice white shape of Minnesota. Now I'm going to place the colored image. So that's this one, the Twins 1 JPEG. And now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to image trace it, but I'm going to image trace this with colors. So there aren't too many colors in this image, so I'm going to do 16 colors. And when it's done, I have to expand it again. So I'm going to hit expand. And I'm going to get rid of that white border again like I did before. So I'm going to right click, isolate the group. I'm going to select that rectangle and hit the delete key. And the last thing I got to do now with this image is move it and get it to the correct size as the outline. So I'm going to select all. So that's the Control and the A key. And I'm going to put it at 0, 0. So I'm in the transform menu. And then I'm going to make the size, the height, 5 inches. And I have the chain linked so that the width automatically changes as well. And I'm going to hit the tab key. And now it's right over the other cut contour. So if I double click out and zoom in, so control and plus to zoom in, you will see that there is this cut contour behind it. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more so that you can kind of see this. And you'll notice you can see that cut contour. If I go into my layers, so under Window, Layers, I can turn off and on these different layers so you can see the path. So I'm going to turn off the picture so you can see that. Turn it back on, it's right over that. So that cut contour is ready to go. I'm going to zoom out with the control and the minus key. We don't want all this white. So the last thing I'm going to do is go to Object and Artboards and Fit to Artwork Bounds, because the machine will think that we have to print all the white as well. So now this is ready to save. So I'm going to go to File and Save As, and we're going to change it from an Illustrator file to a PDF, so Adobe PDF. The print and cut machine needs to have PDF files. So I'm going to save this as Twins 1, just like all the other ones, but this time it's going to be a PDF file. I'm saving it to my desktop and hit save. And it always comes up with another menu. Just hit save again. So that's ready to go. It's ready to be cut on our print and cut vinyl cutter. The next video will show you how to take that file and send it to the printer. Have a nice day.